Heavenly Father, in the authority that you have given unto us, we pray for the body of Christ, the church, the bride, in our communities. We pray for a spirit of unity to break out among the churches in our communities. We pray that churches would band together as a unified army so as to effectively win the lost in their towns together. We pray that the church, the body of Christ, would see the enemy and understand that we are not to fight against each other. We pray that the church will allow the Holy Spirit to move freely and have full reign according to your word, Father. We pray, Father God, that there will be no division, but there will be unity as you have called us to walk as one in you. That is your heart. That is your will. So I pray for the hearts of everyone that has come into the knowledge of knowing and accepting you, Father God, as their Lord, as their God, as their King, as the great shepherd, as the Almighty God, as the only true and living God. Turn the hearts of your children back to the Father. We come against denominational walls. Bring them down, Father, and let there be a oneness. Let there be unity in you. No more division, but one vision in Christ Jesus. Father, we pray for our families, and we ask you to bring healing and restoration to our families, Father. We ask you to break the back of the spirit of rebelliousness, and that you will restore family altars in our homes, families of prayer, and bring revival into our families, into our private homes, Father. We ask you, Father, now to bring that which you have established in the beginning, in Genesis, the union of one man and one woman as our establishment, as our foundation of the family, Father. We ask you, Father, to bless our mothers and our fathers, Lord God, to be excellent parents, that we will raise up our children in the way that they should go, and when they're older, they will not depart from you, Father, because we have not only spoken the word over their lives, but we have been living epistles before them to give them the example that they are to follow as they live out this life according to your word, Lord God. I thank you and I praise you now, Father, for our families, for our marriages, for our children, Father. I pray that you will protect our children, Father, from all hurt, from all harm, and from all danger, seen and unseen, Father. I decree and I declare a supernatural divine hedge of protection around them now, Father, wherever they may be, Father. Whether it be in our homes, whether it be in the schoolyard, Father, in the classroom, Father, wherever they may be, Father, we ask you to place a divine hedge of protection that nothing by any means shall harm them, Lord God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray for our educational system. We pray for our teachers that they will love the Lord Jesus. We pray, Father, for a radical spirit that would dare to challenge ungodly rules in our educational system. And we pray that they will bring in a righteous revolution for the sake of our children, Father. We ask you to cover our educationers in the system that has been set up to pour into our children, our now generation, our future generations, Father. Pray for them now, Lord God. Give them the wisdom that they need. Give them the skills that they need, Father, that they will effectively pour into the lives of our youth. In the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for our government establishment. We pray, Lord, that you would raise up godly leaders in our government system. We pray that you would bless those who are in authority over us. We pray for their protection. We pray for a spirit of wisdom on their behalf. We pray that the Lord would bring to them the mentality that they have need of in this hour. Raise up Daniels in our governmental system that will provide godly counsel, that they will speak the heart of the Father. They will speak your will, and not only speak your will, but do your will with boldness and courage, Father. We pray on today, Father, that you would bless our media. We pray for a desire for purity and righteousness to infiltrate our media. Do warfare against gossiping spirit and murderous spirits. We ask you, Lord, to bring a spirit of integrity into those who work in the media. We pray against the spirit of manipulation. Father, you know each and every individual. You know their heart's intent. And so we pray for programming that is in alignment with your word, your will, and your ways. We come against the spirit of sorcery. We come against the spirit of backbiting. We come against the spirit of competitiveness that will bring division and discord. But let there even in the media system be a oneness, that they will speak the truth. They will speak the truth over the airways in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for the arts and entertainment industry. Father, we pray that you would raise up gifted individuals that are true worshipers in the arts, that you would be glorified through their paintings and their sculptures and their songs and their written works, in drama, in plays, stage productions, movies, CDs, over all audio, over all written material, over all visual materials. Father, bring forth your righteousness. Bring forth your heart, that we will have sound entertainment that will not only entertain our flesh, but will speak to our spirit man in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for businesses. We pray that daily Bible studies are going forth and prayer meetings. We pray, Father, that even in our places of worship, let there be a revival even in the workplaces. We pray for the strengthening of Christian business owners, CEOs, managers, and workers, that they would be ministers of the gospel even in their places of work. We call forth companies, leaders, and workers who would build their places of business for the glory of God. And we declare an abundance of resources consecrated for the kingdom of God. We thank you now, Father, according to your word, that as we command those who are rich in this present age, not to be haughty, nor to trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God, who gives us richly oil and all things to enjoy, let them do good, that they may be rich in good works, ready to give, willing to share, storing up for themselves a good foundation for the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life. We thank you now, Father, that whatever is needed, you shall provide, because you are Jehovah Jireh, our provider. I thank you now, Father, for covering every aspect of our communities, covering every aspect of our homes. I decree a hedge of protection according to Psalm 91, that nothing by any means shall bring down what you have established according to your word, Father. We decree your kingdom come, your will be done in earth as it is in heaven. in our businesses, Father God, in our places of worship, Father God, in our governmental system, Father God, in our educational system, in the media, arts and entertainment. I thank you and I praise you now that it is so, and it shall not be otherwise. In Jesus' name.